Nang araw sa inyo, aking ipresent sa inyo ang ating lesson for music fourth grading at kung paano nyo sasagutan ang mga activities. Para sa ating lesson ngayon third quarter, ang ating topic is all about the music of the Romantic period. So that was from 1820 to 1910. Romantic period is described as a cultural movement that stressed emotion, imagination, individualism, and freedom of expression. So, base dyan from the word romantic, anything that involve or stressed emotion ay pumapasok sa romantic period. These characteristics are evident in music, art, literature of the era. Nationalism was also incorporated in the music of the Romantic period. Romantic period is not limited to a love romance. Ang nasyonalismo o ang pagmamahal sa sariling bayan ay itinuturing din as form of romantic music. An example of composition that shows nationalism is the Polonaise of Frédéric Chopin, which is a dance composition for piano and is famous in Poland until today. So ngayon, pag-usapan natin kung sino-sino ba ang mga sikat na composer during Romantic period. Ang una ay si Niccolò Paganini. He was born on October 27, 1782 in Genoa, Italy, in a family of six children. His musical skill started with playing mandolin at the age of five. He eventually transferred his training to violin at the age of seven with different violin professor in Italy. Kung makikita nyo sa naka-bold letters, there is a rumor about his amazing violin skills that was said to be a gift from the devil. May mga balita din na nagsasabi na ipinalit niya ang kanyang soul in exchange for those skills. He was also rumored to have a problem with women and gambling. But at any rate, Niccolò Paganini was one of the best composer on the Romantic period. Ang susunod naman is si Frédéric Chopin. He was known as the poet of the piano. Was born on March 1, 1810 in Zielazowa, Poland. He began to play piano at the age 4. He composed Polonaise at the age of 7. On the bold part, makikita natin yung highlighted part is he wrote almost exclusively for piano. Kaya nga siya ay tinaguri ang poet of the piano dahil earlier on his life, talagang piano ang kanyang laging tinutugtog. Chopin composed almost primarily for the piano and some of his most well-known compositions are Fantasy in F minor, Opera 49, Revolutionary Etude, Opera 10, Number 12, and 24 Preludes, Opera 28. Next is Franz Liszt. The best word that describes the work of Franz Liszt is virtuosity. He was known as the virtuoso pianist, a composer, and the busiest musician during the Romantic era. He played and studied in Vienna and Paris while performing in concert and in the rest of the Europe. His father was his teacher at age 6. A turning point came when in his early 20s, Liszt heard the virtuoso violinist Niccolò Paganini perform, so he decided to dedicate himself in becoming a virtuoso pianist. He was known for his symphonic poems where he translated great literary works. Next is Robert Schumann. One of the most famous romantic composer that beautifully combined music and words is Robert Schumann. He was a composer and a music critic. Robert Alexander Schumann was born in 1810. On the bold part, makikita natin that his father wanted him to study law. Ibig sabihin, tungkol sa pagiging law ang gusto ng kanyang father, but nag-aral siya sa Leipzig to study law, pero in-spend niya ang most of his time with musical and literary circle. Dahil ang pangarap talaga ni Robert Schumann ay in the world of music. Schumann founded the music journal, Journal New Strip for Music. Next is Hector Berlioz. He is a French composer born on December 11, 1803. At his young age, he learned to play guitar and flute but never became skilled in a specific musical instrument. His father was a physician who sent Hector to medical school, but he ended up pursuing a career in music. One of his famous musical composition is a 5-movement symphony called Symphony Fantastic. In this composition, which is also known as Fantastic Symphony, he showcases the importance feature in his composition in creating tone color. He assembled hundreds of musicians to produce a powerful sound. Next is Peter Kaikovsky. He was born on May 7, 1840 in Russia. Peter Kaikovsky openly admit that he is a big fan of Mozart. That's why Kaikovsky studied composition of Mozart and moved to Moscow and started teaching at the new conservatory. He continued his music career in New York despite having marital problems and became famous after composing the musical poem Phantom and Romeo and Juliet. He composed haunting melodies and used great deal of folk music. On the bold part, makikita nyo na his fame peaked in the last 10 years of his life and later died due to cholera. And the last one is Camille Saint-Saëns. He was known as a talented musician from an early age. He was born in Paris and started his music through the help of his aunt by teaching him piano lesson when he was only 2 years old. Afterward, he began composing piano piece at the age 3. He was considered as a composer who creates elegant music, neat, clean, polished, and never excessive. One of these is The Swan. As an organist and one of the best pianists of his time, he sat very still at the piano and played gracefully and cool. So sa lahat ng nabanggit na composer, mag-focus kayo dun sa highlighted part. Ito naman ang lyrics ng paubayan ni Moira de la Torre. Alam ko naman na ito ay sikat na sikat at marami sa inyo ang may alam ng kanta ng paubaya. Kaya if you do not know this, I encourage you to listen to this one for the application of our lesson. Sa pagsasagot naman ng inyong task, ang first learning task is read the question carefully and encircle the letter of the correct answer. So it is just a basic multiple choice. Bilugan nyo lang yung tamang sagot. For the second part, identify the composer of the Romantic period from each column. Highlight or encircle your answer. So sa number 1, Johann Sebastian Bach, Franz Schubert, or Wolfgang Mozart, bilugan nyo kung sino yung Romantic composer. For this one, dyan sa space, magdodrawing kayo ng poster showing the life story, buhay ng isa sa mga composer na nabanggit sa ating lesson. Siyempre, panatiling malinis at maayos ang inyong drawing dahil kasama ang kalinisan at kaayusan sa pagkakaroon ng grade dito. Next is listening activity. So, mamimili kayo, may pagpipilian kayo. Una, La Campanella. Number 2 is The Swan from Carnival of the Animals. The 3 is Symphony Fantastic. And number 4 is Nocturne Opera 9, number 1, B minor. Ilagay nyo lang yung title ng napili nyo at kung sino ang composer. And what can you say about the music? Paano nyo malalaman ang music? Siyempre, you look at the YouTube at makinig. For this one, listen to Moira de la Torre's Paubaya. After listening, fill up the needed data below for musical analysis. What can you say about the song? What is the message of the song? And what line or lyric struck you the most? Siyempre, kung alam nyo naman itong kanta at memorize nyo naman, pwede nyo namang hindi napakinggan. Or siyempre, baka naman meron na kayong downloaded version sa inyong mga cellphone. At alam ko namang puro hugot ang kantang ito. And syempre, last but not the least to answer about paubaya, if you were to sing paubaya to someone, who would that person be and why? For the next part, the reflection is complete the following unfinished sentences. My understanding about the music of the Romantic period is that I realized that most of the instrumental music from the Romantic period are. The reason why I really appreciate instrumental music from the Romantic period is because I love listening to the Romantic music composition because, and the composer that I like most is blank because. Okay, so yan lang ang mga sasagutan nyo para sa ating third grading music. Maraming salamat at nawa ay makapagpasa kayo ng mga activity. Sa mga nagtatanong kung saan nyo sasagutan, pakisagutan na lang doon sa papel na ibinigay ng paaralan para hindi na kayo bumili ng bagong papel.